Operations report. Two Liberator Delta Ones have crashed and are written off. Ah, crap. Two separate ones, not and one kills the pilot even. Arrgh! This is a very not good last turn. Repairs are complete. Contact report. We hit a sub chaser. That's great. At 5490, I think that's near Singapore. We'll double check that. Oh, was there another contact report? Another hit here. No, I guess not. Recon over Iwo, recon over Tanjung Pinang, Chichijima. Contact report. Kill credits. Seawolf is hit. Uh-oh. This is a very not good turn, but we return the favor. An E-boat escort Suzuki is hit. At 5086. That's they're pretty close to the same place. And it's a Vengeance. I think the Vengeance, when they're on naval attack and on search, they appear to be a little bit more aggressive. Maybe we'll sink it. Maybe it'll sink. But we're not getting a dedicated airstrike. Maybe it's too the targets are too small to attract an actual airstrike. All right. Contact report. Recon over Langkawi. Here are all the transports on their practice missions. Look at that. Lots of transports flying. Hundreds of transports flying. Hundreds? I would say probably about 200. Close to 200 transports are flying. Just to try to gain some experience. Taking replacements. Here's something interesting. This is the 6th Chinese Corps that I was hoping to upgrade. It's upgraded at Hong Kong, even though it's separate now. I wonder what the hell's going to happen with the extra unit, with the fragment. We have two reinforcements, Seattle and Eastern USA. Here's the 6th Chinese Corps. Oh, great, we got all, we have 316. That must have been all that was there. All that we could get at the time. 837, so we'll just have to keep adding them with these darned replacements. That could take forever. Makes me wonder what's going to happen with these guys when they finally link up. Are they just going to immediately upgrade? I hope so. Hong Kong, two transports waiting. Shanghai, we have one damaged Shad. We'll throw him into critical. The other three subs, yep, I see three subs, three zones, off they go. The operations report listed an attack on a sub chaser at 5490, that must be this group here, and an attack on the E-boats, and a hit and a sinking, supposedly, of an E-boat over here. It seems to me as though these little patrol craft aren't enough to garner a strike by the AI. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase the number of search aircraft. We'll search 50% search. By putting more aircraft out there, all they need is one little bomb hit during their search routine to destroy the enemy. And I'm going to do the same thing with the Mitchells. Of course, this means that there are less aircraft available to bomb Tanjung Pinang, but we're not in a real rush to destroy them anyway. It's the ships I want to destroy first and foremost. We've seen... Now that we're already over here, I'm just going to do another thing. We have no more enemy on the peninsula, on Asia proper. We can't cross over here unless we want to bring ships in, and I don't want to waste ships doing that. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to make sure the units that we have, this Chinese corps is capable, can be purchased for a few 1,500 points or so. A lot of points. But I also want him to upgrade to 1943 squad. So let's make sure we turn these on now. These are the ones that can actually travel. So I want to make sure that they'll upgrade if humanly possible. I can't choose just the Chinese units, or I can't sort it by Chinese units. These units are not going to do it because this is a waste. These guys cannot leave the continent. No point upgrading them. Just giving away squads that might be needed. Even though I might have lots of extra squads, I will probably be taking some casualties. So even though I have enough to upgrade other units, I won't, simply because on principle they aren't going to be leaving the continent. So those three units, 1, 2, and what was that, just two? May have only been two. Looks like only two that can actually leave the continent. Okay. This turn was just brutal on the bombers. At Fusan, the last Chinese corps has arrived, so we'll throw it into combat mode. Because they're in different commands, we aren't able to recombine them. Not even the option is not available to us. The bombers, these guys up here sure took a licking. First off, we better turn off. Wait. We will turn on all the other bombers because it's now the other B-24 turn to attack. First, we'll set all level bombers here like this, and then we will set this one to rest. This one had a crash. We lost a plane here, so I'm going to make sure we add one and request a pilot. It's just like it has to sort through 1,700 pilots. Let's make sure. Yeah, these are all qualified. Look at that. It's a high skill pilot. We lost a good one. We lost a good guy. There's one guy at the bottom who's kind of a dud. I guess I forgot to take him out last turn. He's still training. This guy should be training. So now we're going to request two pilots. These guys are. We may as well take the top, right? Top two guys? Sure. Of course, now we have to go back manually to this one and activate them. Okay, so now we are overstacked here. Too many, 479 out of 400. So too many planes are active. We'll now take the Delta Ones. Delta One, we'll order them to rest, and the entire group of Delta Ones are going to rest. This one also lost a pilot and a plane, so we'll add another plane replacement. Bomber pilot, we'll take one. Again, he fits in right. He fits in with all the other ones. He's actually one of the low men on the totem pole. There we go. Now these pilot. Oh, let me show down here. Keijo. Keijo, we've gotten our double. There you go. That now aviation support, 360. So I guess it took a day to somehow kick in, maybe to take effect. Maybe it has to go over level 8. Maybe slightly over. Maybe that turn it was built into level 8, so it doesn't really click. But now all these aircraft that are recuperating or recovering. Here's another Delta One. Look at that. We lost four bombers today. That's a huge amount. We're going to fly these guys down to Keijo. Keijo. They're going to rest. And they might as well rest down there. See? By amalgamating them all on one field, I'm hoping that it'll reduce any confusion. So we'll take all these. And after the next one launches their strike, they will also shuttle down to Keijo. Now, we haven't talked, I haven't said anything about the organization of these, mainly until we get them all together. But planes that fly of the same command, there are often coordination problems. See, there's two, most of these planes, there's 7th Bomber Command, 5th Bomber Command, and 11th United States Air Force. By having units flying from different commands, there are coordination problems. And in my opinion, if there are three waves, let's say all the 5th bomber goes in together, the 7th bomber goes together, and then the 11th flies their own. So three waves, I think it gives the enemy three times as many chances to intercept. I'm not sure how it works with anti-aircraft. Maybe they only still get one shot, but to swamp an enemy is better than to give him successive waves. So over here on Keijo, we have all the aircraft waiting. Yep, recovering, recovering, recovering. Holy cow, did we just damage another one here? No, that. There is a damaged one. It's coming by rail. That's fine. That's fine. We're stuck to 260, and we are still only using 236 of the air of the 360 aviation support available. Great. Once the bombers are gone from Changchun, I think I'll move their fighters. I'll send them down to Fusan to aid the effort. Looking at the losses, today's losses, that's not bad, right? One loss, air-to-air loss for 44. But you got to look at the whole big picture. Overall, the enemy lost 54 aircraft by flak and by operational loss. This is the way I look at it. And I lost 18. That's 8, so that's 18 to 54. It's only 3-1. Not so good anymore, is it? Plus, I lost pilots killed. Let's take a look at the aircraft losses, and we'll see. Look today. We'll see that we lost 4 Skytrain for just the training. We didn't even use them very much, except a little bit over in Chittagong. The other ones, we lost 4 for just flying of supplies, 1 hex. I gotta really think hard, long and hard. Is it worth 4 aircraft per turn, killing, destroying the aircraft, possibly killing the pilots, just to get a little bit of training? And I'm leaning towards, I think I'm going to shut down that operation, just send them back to regular training missions. They don't get as much, they don't get any experience or much experience. They don't get very much skill. But the price in aircraft and pilots, I think, is a little bit too high. With the reduced need for with the reduced aircraft on Changchun, we now have Changchun. It's only 103 support required, so I can send one of the base forces away. These are doubled up because of the size, so I'm going to send this one all the way down to Fusan. And we'll move the rest once the aircraft leave next turn. I'll continue. I'll bring more base forces back up here to use it, and or at Harbin to use it as a training base to bomb Heilun. But right now, Fusan and Jinhae are short, quite not quite badly, but short enough, noticeably short. They need the help. Keijo, we're gonna keep hitting. We'll take the bombers out. Where's the recon? Oh, here's the recon. The recon, switch up. We'll maintain. Uh-oh, Tokuyama. Right, Hiroshima. This could be, well, not the greatest idea because of all the flak, but I do want those ships. Look at all that. Tanker, there's repair ships and AKE replenishment ships here. So yeah, I could go in during the day, and I might be doing that once we get the fighters in here to sweep forward on it. But until that time, until we can get some in here, it's not a choice. I don't want to. I'll be throwing away even better bombers. The column is moving southwesterly to the attack. Here's a. We got bombed, so we dropped into combat mode, pushed them back into movement mode. I'm waiting. This one has moved 14 now, so it moves 7 per day. It'll take a week in order to get around here to surround. I'm okay with that. If we can crush all 7 of these units, that's fine by me. I'm trying to move this headquarters unit into the woods here so we can totally surround Orshan. The enemy does not seem to be moving outwards. We've taken Nunkang, and the column is now going to move over to Sunwu. With this fortress destroyed, we're now going to move everyone up to the next fortress in the line. Set all to march. Yeah, we're going to have to divide this just to make sure that... try to recover a little bit on the road. Wow. Just wow. That one fortress held us up for... Did anyone count? A week? Was it? Maybe more? Just couldn't kill it. An immobile fortress. Boy, he took a lot of... He damaged a lot of us. Artillery's going head over. We're going to leave one... which one? The core or the war headquarters? This is aimed for Mishan, which is... Oh, I guess it doesn't really matter. We need to keep one here, because look at this red line here, on here. Once we attack Yankee, the enemy will be able to squirt out if we don't take care. So I've got to leave one unit here. We'll send the core headquarters along, because it's only got a range of one. The army headquarters can stay behind because it's got a range of five. Already he has, Mishan is only at a range of four, so he can lend its command influence. I'm going to start shuffling down from Harbin now. We don't need the aircraft up here, so we're just going to move slowly. Three to turn, lots of time to move down to Kirin, and then make the long train ride down. So Kirin, and then Tunghua, and then probably Heijo. Oh, crud. Looking at this, how sloppy of my play. Here's a unit that was moving, Chinese Provincial 8th Corps, moving towards, set for Heiho, which is up here, I guess, as a garrison. What it did was it moved, right, instead of moving up this way, it moved across! Stupid bastards. Why? You can't move up this way! Anyway, because he's got assault value here, he's probably going to capture Heilun before we can get the hell out of here. God, you incredible idiots! Gonna try my best to get out of here so that we don't auto capture him, but I can't. He probably will. And I've been trying to save this base so that I don't want to capture it so that I can use it as a bombing target. Good. God, there's no way to figure out, keep track of all this stuff. Really. Okay. So I got to reevaluate. We've got this wonderful base up here at Harbin. We can expand it to a level 9 base. And then we could have just bombed this empty base all day long, training. It's the same way we were using Nakhon Ratchasima for that. But if it gets captured, well, you can't bomb it anymore, right? And maybe this one gets captured too, Longchen. I hope not. Well, I don't even know. What do you bomb on this? What do you attack on? Something like, you can't. I don't think you can. There's nothing there. There's no base. I don't think it'll let you bomb it. A dot base. Okay. I guess we'll see if any of these bases are empty. We know that this one's occupied. This one's occupied. This one's occupied. So. Unless I want to, God! Think long and hard about that. This is a small base. I'm not sure it's worth. It's a level 6 base. So this is Mutangang is the same size as Harbin. We could build this one up and then just bomb the living daylights out of Kiamus without capturing it. Just surround it with headquarters squads, but there are 7 units here, and those Air Force battalions, they have some assault value. They're not totally defenseless, so it'll take a while to bomb that out. It would be nice if this one was empty. This one from here to here is a range of 5, and not all aircraft have that range of 5. You got those little bombers, the little Lysander and the Wapitis and whatnot. that we can use for training, but that might be too far away. Well, maybe this, maybe, no, I'm pretty sure Sun Wu and Heiho are going to be occupied. This is probably another border fortress. We'll have to actually punch them out. And these two are also occupied. So this was pretty much the last chance we had for an unoccupied base to use just as a bomb zone. Oh, well, just those little things you just gotta keep track of. On a more positive note, Hankou, the first base forces have arrived. They're on the rail line. I think we can send them all the way to Fuzan. Yeah! Set all to march. That wasn't so bad. This is actually more enjoyable. The other units are still coming through. Oh, this one's going to Hong Kong. Is it needed in Hong Kong still? Let's check Hong Kong. Did the base forces, if they have radar, we may not need to. No, they're still struggling with sound detectors here. But it's nice to know, once this one arrives, we can send one of the Chinese base forces out to Korea. More units arrived here. Okay, this is heading for Hankou. Everybody here. Well, just in case, even though I'm heading for Hankou, the other ones, I'm not sure if they are. Just in case, we'll just say set all to march. That'll cover them. If they're already heading there, it will not cancel their movement. More arrived in Langson. These guys are empty, are without a destination, so we'll say Hankou. This one's heading, oops. Okay, these guys are already heading there, and this one's heading down for Pakoy. Nice and quiet on the coast. We also have Amoy. I think one of them upgraded. One of them has upgraded, so I don't need to send a base force over to Amoy. Not right away, at least. Quinhon. He's still packing. Let me see. Would it allow us to go to Hong Kong? No direct. So we'll have to take the rail up and then over and then across. Saigon. Everybody here. Well, the Somerset Light Infantry. Okay, firstly, we'll send these guys. Can we send them all the way to Liu Chao? I'm a little weary. If I send them to Liu Chao, look how slowly these damn things are going. These guys are idiots! I think I better send them to Langson just in case, because these guys are morons. The Somerset Light Infantry will go to Quinhon to relieve them and allow the Quinhon garrison to recombine with the 6th Corps. These guys, okay, this is supposed to go to Hankou, going up all this way. If it had gone the other direction, it would already be there. Oh, I was willing to try something, but maybe I should. Like these guys, they're heading for Hankou, and they're jerking around in the rear. This one, I'm thinking, turn around, get back down, both of ya. Yeah, two turns to travel from here up to there? Are you freaking kidding me? Get back down to Saigon. Oh, God, what idiots. Oh, well. These guys are heading for Saigon. And Sok Trang is... Well, it's repairing, okay. More have arrived here. The engineering battalion. Let's see. Can we get them all the way over to Quinhon? Yeah! Well... I guess that's better than nothing, right? I don't want him... Oh, God. Coming up to... That would be too stupid, wouldn't it? You never know. Never know. Singapore. We have one submarine ready to go. Don't be anal about it. Send him out. Okay. The patrol zone, I don't know. Where shall we set it? There doesn't seem to be a lot of traffic heading towards Batavia. So maybe I'll just keep setting it on a barrier patrol here. Now, we've already talked about the aircraft. We wiped out all enemy presence on Malaya, and except for this off island, and we'll hopefully bomb it into submission or bomb it into oblivion in the not too far future. Okay, this one, let's see. I'm going to let the Chindits here try to repair Taiping if they can fix it up before they leave. We've got a hell of a lot of units here. A lot of them, but not a lot of them, but damaged. Some are disrupted, some are disabled. But most of these can be shipped to Japan. So this is what I'm planning to do with them. The Chinese units that can go are going to head over to, I've set them for upgrade, and they're going to head over to, I think Shanghai is probably the best place. I don't want to transship from Fusan. It's closer if I want to launch an invasion from here, but if I can get to Shanghai and then pick them up, sail across over to Kochi, that might be the best. Or if we've liberated Hiroshima by that time, Nagasaki, maybe we can ship directly. All the units that cannot move, these ones, the 2059, this is a massive unit. Look at that. This is a fully operational, probably the biggest unit. And it's got a 769 assault value right now, so it's probably going to be over 775 assault value overall. Can't move it. Can't get rid of it. Can't do anything. Can't disband it for the pieces. Can't do anything. What I've done is I had to write down all the garrison requirements for every pissant little city in India and Rangoon and Mandalay and Pangshan and all the other throughout here, and even the one in Thailand. Wrote down all the garrison requirements, and I broke these guys up. This is a massive unit, 700. Even when it's divided, it's going to be 250. That's way more than any garrison. Most of the garrisons here are 120, or usually 20 or 30, or less, or 10. But the units holding these garrisons are able to move. These guys can transship to Japan. So that makes that it. It's not their combat power, it's their ability to actually leave Asia. Get on a ship and leave Asia. So for that reason, I'm going to use these great big massive ones as small as possible, but even for something with a 60 garrison, I have to leave 257, just because that's as small as it gets. So I'm sending all the Chinese units that are landlocked. We're going to move up here, we're going to kill this stack, and then we're going to march over to India and replace all these other units here, like this one. It's a tiny little unit, 34. Ahmedabad only has garrison requirement of 30, but we're probably going to drop a couple hundred on there. What else are you going to do with it? There's no one else to fight. Now the Aussies and everybody else, and this one, we just need political points to buy it. We don't have enough now. We will move them. Oh, we're sending them over. I'm going to stop off just in front of Haiphong. Haiphong, I want to capture it because Haiphong might actually get some reinforcements, and then the enemy would have a foothold on the continent. So we're going to go up to Hanoi, march down, punch out Haiphong, and then continue over. We're not in a real rush to get to Shanghai, as the invasion hasn't launched yet. And this is going to be the second and third waves probably. I'll leave the engineers here. The armor is going. The engineers are going to stay and build the bases here and move along slowly. What they'll probably do is move along from one base to another to another to another to just complete them. but to build them all up to level 9 bases before we leave. They're not worth very much. They're only worth 2 points. So it's not, I'm not, there's no rush, whereas the point, whereas the bases over here are worth usually 5 points. So it's always better to build these than to build these. A 5 multiplier. The armor will also go off. There's a lot of units that are leaving this turn. Not this turn, but let's see. Where are they? Like the not close to sure. A lot of these little guys, they're going to withdraw in 2 days. So they're got it just in time. So I'll use the Chinese units to destroy the rest of this Japanese column and then move up. We're going to put the garrisons in Mandalay, in Paoshan, in Calcutta. It's going to look really weird with all these Chinese units in India, but needs must. Lastly, this King's Own Light Infantry, this is a look at all these different components of the 39th Indian Division. The 11th Rifles Battalion, Burmese Rifles, was destroyed. But all these other ones can be recombined, except for this one. Right now, it's in the wrong headquarters. So we need to switch it back to Burma headquarters. And then, are these two of these? Oh, two of these need to be switched. This one needs to be switched to Burma headquarters. Oh, wow, that's a lot of points. But I'll do it now. As well as this one. The reason why I want these all combined is... where's that? Burma headquarters. Burma Corps. So a lot of points blasted, wasted here. We're going to rebuild this because as long as the units are separate, they can. It's nice. It's good. Light flexibility. They're small. I can get them into garrisons, and whatnot. But I don't want them as garrisons. I want them so that they can move off. So I don't want to waste them as garrisons. When they're individual like this, there's a little bit of space between them or gaps, so the unit doesn't build up to all the strength of an entire division. Once they recombine, then they can take on replacements for all those missing little pieces that feel like the glue on a puzzle. So now we will recombine. By recombining, here's the entire table of organization. Whereas if you had added up all each and every one of the little ones, components, they would not have yielded this 108 and whatever else. So for that reason, I've recombined them. Now that where's that Burmese? Oh, it's a very weak unit. It's the 39th unit. Burma, was it the 39th? This one, 39th Indian Division. It's a very weak unit, right? Only 50 assault strength, but at least has a chance to build up to maximum assault strength. So we'll do the same thing. We're marching them across and hopefully getting ready for assault on Japan. One final note. Of the infantry divisions, infantry units, I'm sending one back. Which one? It's 3rd Brigade, I think it is. It's an yes, 3rd Indian Brigade. 3rd Indian Brigade is part of the Punjab Division, Northern Command. There are two others in Lahore, and this one's a lower star. This one cannot be changed command wise. We'll turn off the upgrade because we don't want them to take valuable squads from other units. I'm sending him back to China, to India, so that he can combine with these other two. They cannot leave the continent because they are a restricted command. Once they are recombined, I'm going to see if I can't send them somewhere, Delhi or Karachi or Bombay, somewhere. See if there's a place we can actually disband the units, break them down for their individual components, for their squads. I don't know if this is possible because it's restricted, But we're going to try. What else are you going to do with these guys? There's no one to fight. No one to fight. All they're doing is eating up. One thing I wanted to note was these units are... Where the heck was that? It was 3rd Brigade. Boy. Yes, 3rd Indian Brigade. These are the two units here. When they started, I'll go over to Lahore. When the game started, these units were they were static. Somehow they were static. I sent them to upgrade at some point, and I don't know what happened to them, but I don't think anything changed. I thought it was the Frontier Scouts that made them static, but I don't think it was, because the Frontier Scouts were here at the beginning of the game, and they're here now. So I don't know what happened or why or when they got changed, but somehow, it's one of those things, they got changed. Now they are mobile. We can move these. We can change them. So once the Chinese units come, I'll recombine it. Hopefully, maybe, when they recombine into the Punjab division, maybe I can move them somewhere and disband the whole lot of them. Or else use them for their engineers. That's about all we can. But still, recombining them should allow them to grow be a little bit bigger, a little bit stronger, perhaps, with more engineers to fill in those holes. There's Lahore, and there's another one at Rawalpindi. Rawalpindi, same situation. You have two of them here. They from the beginning of the game, they were static like this. All of a sudden, then at some point in time, they just switched. I missed it. I don't know what the upgrade was. I don't think I ever got a message, but probably did. These guys will combine with their missing brigade down at Lucknow. Notice these guys can't leave the continent, but maybe we can use them for something once they build or disband. A couple of anti-aircraft units have arrived at Mulmian. We'll send them marching down to Bangkok. The transport we were testing with these transports, I don't think I'm going to do it. Costing 4 per day, it's just too expensive. So we're just going to go back to standard training. What? All transports. Just regular training. We'll do this. Oh, were there any others here? Yeah, we'll do that at the other location in Australia. The ships had arrived here. Now we've got some supplies at Chittagong, and we're going to put the rest of these transports into the pipeline. We're moving it slowly and surely. Oh well, I think as soon as we get it up to Rangoon, it pretty much just drains it, which is okay, which is fine. More of these. Look at all these. Units arriving Shuibo. Okay. Oops. The 221st RAF group has all arrived, and the 175th wing has arrived. So we'll now already in strategic mode, so set all to march. The last one, 173rd wing, isn't here yet. We're going to cancel this one. There's one more flight required. Take a look at the transports. Yeah, everyone else, these guys have already dropped into supply, so we'll send them into training. Look, this dead pilots. This is an indication of dead pilots. These are all the supposedly experienced guys. Maybe we killed one of the newbies. Maybe. But we'll pound these guys back out. 5 more. We'll grab all those newbies that we had taken out here. Wow, look, take that long to call them. Oops, no, oops. I wish I could call up, select the ones in the middle here. That's the ones I want to upgrade. You know, I can't be bothered. I'm just going to grab the ones out of the bottom. Why? Because it's easy. I can just click this. But it's not the ones I want. Well, it's not worth the clicks, man. It's just not worth the hassle of it all. So, yeah, I have to play at suboptimum because it's just a pain in the butt to do anything else. So we're grabbing these guys out of the bottom. We'll train them.
activate everybody. Yeah, I know. What a hassle. Quiet in Ceylon. The transport battleship convoy moves outward. Uneventfully, convoy coming landed at Bombay, unloading. Convoy heading out. Nothing happening other than just convoys in and out of Abadan and Aden. No reinforcements, South Africa. Submarine check. Whoa, lots of damaged ones. Okay. Whale. We know got hit. Guard fish and sea wolf. Sea wolf got hit. Wow, this is how you lose submarines. Thank you for the button. Back we come. Those are the only three. Double check. Yep. No other ones. Check for endurance. Oh, looks like we got one. O20 has... Yep, we're running. Thank you for the button. Shark, trout, and poji. All in. Checking for torpedoes. Sunfish was the only one to fire, and she still has plenty remaining. Enemy group detected near Timor, but it looks like it's just a... Well, we don't know. We know there's an E-boat escort and nothing more. Don't know if it's an invasion group or just a patrol group. Our destroyers have returned safely to Townsville. Whew, we survived that. The minesweepers are still out, right on top of a submarine, but they're not engaging. Well, that's why there's practice, I guess. This is what we need. On Bowen! Oh my goodness, the damaged ship has gone... jumped into port. We are at 62 major. We're not going to be able to repair any more for this, so we may as well bring it back up. So, it jumps up to... 73, 75 in one turn. We drop in and we immediately pump it out and off we go again. There's fuel here, so we may as well refuel everybody while we're waiting to go. Then we'll jump down to Rockhampton, maybe to Bundaberg. Yeah, we'll have to drop in Bundaberg, Maryborough, and then Brisbane. This is going to be a long hop. It'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whoa, that's pretty long. Six. We're going to be out for 3 days trying to get in here. At Brisbane, our units are practicing. Here comes the replenishment convoy to Guadalcanal. Submarine detected. New Zealand, still unloading. Convoy passing through. Convoy passing up. This is an aviation seaplane tender coming to relieve Tulagi. Tulagi has a seaplane tender, but it hasn't upgraded. And we get radar and some better anti-aircraft guns, so I think it's worth the effort to relieve it. Nothing in Panama. Quiet at Pearl Harbor. Convoy's moving past. Convoy's arrived. Transport. Okay. They refueled already. Disband. And we'll repair them. Try to load them. The problem is, we have 287,000 only. I thought that when we first saw this, I thought that it was... The problem might have been caused by me using these new maps. But then I realized, no, even at the end of the war, or the first phase of the war, auto victory, it was already a supply problem here. So what I think I'm going to do is, I can cry about it, there's nothing you can do about it. What I'm going to do is send all the troop transports up to Vancouver, and they're going to start running supplies down to Pearl Harbor. It's actually, all the big troop transports. I've got to send some more escorts out here in case there's submarines around here. The number of escorts at Victoria isn't very high. They're not bad, they're just not a heck of a lot. So now we have to cover two ports, It's just more of a hassle. No reinforcements to go, so we'll just load up more supplies, or as many supplies as we can. This transport group, yeah, it's all loaded. So why didn't it go? Oh, it's loading this pissant little amount of fuel. But at least we finished off the rest of it. Okay, cancel and go. The troop transports are heading over to Vancouver. Let's hope this situation rectifies, but if it doesn't, then we'll just have to move things over to Vancouver and work from there. Just silly as all hell. None of these have upgraded. Oh, we do have a reinforcement at Seattle. Oh gosh, I'm just curious now. Form. Okay, well, if if it's here, I'm going to order it to Vancouver. We met. No. We'll send this one down to San Francisco as well. Going the inside passage. Another reinforcement has appeared in the east side. East USA. Form transport. Ah, it's an assault transport. So we'll load supplies. And send it down to Balboa. A lot of convoys arrived this turn. The first New Zealand convoy has come in. There's a couple of big tankers. It's 130,000 worth of fuel trying to get off here. It's just a nightmare. Only 60,000 can dock at a time. The 60,000 points. It's going to take a few days and it's going to hold up all these. Plus, there's more coming. The New Zealanders finally arrived. And they're disgorging theirs. These guys will go back for more to the United States for more supplies, along with two other convoys that have just finished. So we're gonna go. This is kind of the route we're gonna go here. We'll go back down, pick some more up, and head back to Saipan or the Marianas. Also sending heavy cruiser Australia and a couple of the repair ships. These guys have an upgrade coming up on the they've missed an upgrade already. This is the last one. But the another repair ship just arrived, so they're covered while these two go back to Pearl Harbor to upgrade. The carriers are heading up to Hajima. We've lost track of the enemy. We don't have any patrol aircraft over here. I should bring the squadron over. Oh, we don't have room on it right now. So we'll. It was last sighted about here. Don't know where it is. Probably should have done it earlier. I am moving one of the patrol squadrons that was training at Pearl Harbor over to Wake. Now the Wake Island unit is going to transfer up to Hajima. If I could find the darn thing. There we are. It's not good to be blind. So their PB, they're short. They're not really long range. Well, they're a little bit long range. 14 is better than nothing. Right. So the carriers are heading up in case he comes this way. Battleship wise. Our surface combatants. These are our light cruisers that just hammered the enemy. The Marblehead took a couple of hits as well as the Edsel. She got one major flood damage, so I don't think we can repair it here, but we'll disband into the base. We don't need to worry about it any longer. These are kind of the short range. Yeah, these are the 277s. I think we can set these for bombardment. We will hit Hajima again. Chichijima from here. We're going to, the low These are low, so we're going to send these after Okinawa. We will pick up one of the light cruisers. Two of the light cruisers. Any other battleships? Wow, these are... Oops. No. We don't want these because their operations points are... Well, we could use them, but we'll let them rest one turn. Battleship-wise, these thousands are spent, so we'll send five battleships to bombard. That's all right. Take the other group. Change to bombardment. Set for Okinawa. Iwo Jima, pardon me. These battleships with thousands, they've used up all their operational points. They're not going anywhere. The light cruisers, everything. Everything's kind of spent here. Wow. Okay. So we're going to first grab battleships. They got the long way to go. The ones with 100 and under 200, they should have enough operational points left to get them out there. We can't send any cruisers because they don't have any points left on them. Let's see, anybody else? Mine. We can't send these guys, and these guys are already spoken are on the other group. Whoa. We'll take a couple of them. Just more for cover than anything else. So we'll take half of them. Not mission speed, cruise speed, please. The fighters gave a good account of themselves, but they're going to be very tired, so we're going to pull them back to a range of zero. Look at the fatigue in one turn. It jumped up so quickly. We lost a fighter here, so we'll have to get a replacement, break out a replacement. This other flight is also... Oh, where is the rest of it? Hajima. Bring it back down to zero. That's interesting. One's at 15,000, one's at 20,000 for top cover. We're continuing reconnaissance on Chichijima. If this is correct, two units left, we might actually be able to kill off the entire defense. Trigger fires four torpedoes at an enemy submarine. Duds. Rasher! Engaged by an anti-submarine group. On the way in. Rasher bottoming out. We've surfaced. Looks like she's goner. They're destroyed. Caught in the shallow water. Was she coming in or out? But that's a landing ship dock. So this was probably the one that was detected as a carrier over here. So I think it said carrier plus LSD. So I can send the carriers home. It's probably not a sortie from the carrier group. Bombardment Chichijima. Another bomber destroyed on the ground. Squads still being knocked out. Good to see. Bombardment Iwo Jima. Not much, but at least we are still killing them. That's all. That's what it comes down to. We're still getting hits. Uh-oh, same group, looks like. Pickerel fires four torpedoes at an E-boat. Duds. So, look like the subs coming in and out ran right into this anti-submarine group. Another sub attack near Ketapang. Oh, so what are these things now? Well, the subs I sent on to cover this side of the strait. Truant engages or finds sub chaser 28. Ah, great. Pompano fires and hits a tanker. Four hits, she's gone. air attack on the 35th Chinese Corps, CR, no, one squad disabled, headquarters squad. Air attack, Tanjung Pinang. Oh, the vengeance are out. We hit an E-boat three times and a minesweeper four times. Oh, they're gone. Nicely done. Wow, looks like I have to put them on at 50% patrol in order to find them, huh? Wow. Air attack, Alor Star. Ooh, 34 escorts. We throw up 48, almost 100 fighters, and we still break even, barely. Oh, terrible. Fusan, look at all those strike lines. Oh, you didn't see it before. All the different bases attacking Fusan. But they only managed to cobble together 34 strikers. Two fighter bombers shot down. Kota Baru under attack. Wow, the AI is really putting up a good fight all around. Five strikers shot down. Kota Baru under attack again. Two more fighter bombers shot down. Majuro, bombing practice. Jaluit, bombing practice. Akyab, bombing practice. The Navy Venturas hit Langkawi. No damage. Again, one support squad disabled. More bombing practice, Akyab. Tanjung Pinang bombed again. This time we get two squads. No more. Oh, there's still ships out there, but they're not bombing them. So I guess this must be the afternoon attack. Yeah. More bombing practice, Akyab. The Mitchells bomb Tanjung Pinang, disable one headquarters squad. Another headquarters squad bombed. Afternoon attack, Mutankang. We pulled all the fighters out of here. Oh, interesting. So I need to maintain presence with the fighters, perhaps. There's no base. Look at the range of that. He's coming in all the way from the islands. So looks like the enemy likes to bomb Mutankang. So we'll have to maintain some fighter presence in the area. Bombardment Yankee. Another squad disabled.